Hi, we are There Will Be Podcast. My name is Pilar.
My name is Ryan.
And this week we'll be reviewing a Christopher Guest 2000 mockumentary, or should we say dog-umentary? Best in Show! Yes,
yes. So Best in Show, it gives us the inside scoop of the dog show world as we follow the story of the stories of five dogs, or more specifically, their owners slash handlers, as each of them journey from their hometowns all the way to Philadelphia to compete in the annual, very prestigious Mayflower Dog Show.
So this whole movie is just pretty much just following characters around. It is a mockumentary, so we get to learn about the owners. Not really so much about the dogs. I mean, one dog in particular is kind of a mess.
So the first dog slash owners that we meet are Meg and Hamilton. Mm-hmm. They own I believe it's a Weimaraner.
Weimaraner.
I don't know how you pronounce that. That's the breed of dog. The dog's name is Beatrice.
Yes.
And
she's the mess.
Yes. they're from Chicago. We are introduced to them at a couples therapy, I guess?
Yeah, it's like a couples therapy plus their dog.
Yeah, so the dog is a mess compared to the very obedient other dogs of the show, but you get the impression that the dog is a mess because its owners are a complete mess.
Yeah, they are like neurotic, like parents. Like every little thing, they're like hovering around this poor dog, and it's like this poor dog is so pampered to the point to where any tiny inconvenience like throws her off, but like you don't even see the dog being thrown off. Yeah. It's like the parents or the owners are just like one scene in particular that comes to mind is when they are getting ready for the dog show and this dog is showing stress signs to to the owners, and they're like, where's our busy bee.
Yeah.
And the busy bee is just like a little bee with a squeaky toy, and they like freak out because they can't find it. And so they go to their hotel room. They get like the manager and like a maid to help them find the busy bee. They don't find it. They go into a rage. They declare that ICE should come and deport the maid.
Oh, yeah.
And then they go to the dog store. They don't have a bee, Meg, the female owner, she goes into another fit again, just because of a dumb little bee that the dog doesn't even know the difference.
Yeah, I don't know which one of them. One of them has the line like, "If we don't get the busy bee, Beatrice is gonna lose it," something like that.
And the dog is like,
and like, yeah, I mean, they are freaking out the dog basically. Ooh. Because of how neurotic and over the top they are.
Like overbearing. Yeah. Next up we have Winky, who is a little Norwich terrier.
Yes.
Whose owners are Cookie and Jerry. Cookie is played by Catherine O'Hara and Jerry is played by Eugene Levy. If you have seen Schitt's Creek, you've seen that they are the cutest little couple.
Yes.
And they're a couple who is from Florida.
Yeah. Fern City, Florida.
Cookie is kind of known as like the chick who got around in town and all around. And you can get little, there's little hints here and there whenever they like stop at a gas station or a restaurant or a sound booth. There's always a guy who's like, "Cookie, is that you? Do you remember me? 6-inch Jerry?" You know, tiny things like that.
Yeah.
And then Jerry.
Yes.
Jerry is kind of like her golden retriever husband, who kind of just has to stand there and smile every time she gets recognized by a man that she's been busy with. Yeah,
yeah. And he has two left feet.
Oh, he has two left feet.
Literally.
They are a very cute couple. They love their terrier. They even have like little songs that they sing about terriers.
Yeah.
Up to the point to where they create like a whole album.
Yeah, following the dog show, they make an album of
just terrier songs.
About terriers or something, I don't know.
Yeah, it's very cute.
Yeah. Next up from there, we have Hubert, who is a bloodhound. His owner is named Harlan Pepper, who is played by Christopher Guest.
Right, the director.
Yeah, who's also the director of the movie. He is from Pine Nut, South Carolina.
And he loves nuts.
Yeah. Anyway, he is just like one with Hubert. Like, Hubert is like his family member.
Right, yeah.
And yeah, he loves this dog so much. And he's like, a simpleton. Simpleton, yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
He's kind of like a man who's just on island time.
He works at a fishing shop in North Carolina.
Mm-hmm.
And like, he only knows like a couple of things. He knows nuts.
He knows fishing.
He knows about fishing lures and stuff.
Yeah.
He knows about bloodhounds, and he knows about ventriloquism.
That is true. That's upcoming. Yeah. Oh, he's also a beach ball connoisseur. Which is funny because he just lives in the middle of the forest.
But. Yeah. He has a beach ball
collection
like in this log cabin.
Yeah. The next little group that we're seeing is Miss Agnes, who is a little shih tzu. The dog has two gay owners. We have Scott, and then we have Stefan. Scott is kind of like your not so young anymore, but like, you know, what's the word? Like sugar baby.
Yeah.
Like used to be twink character.
Yeah.
And then Stefan is more of like the sugar daddy who I think he was either bisexual and like, because he had a wife beforehand, his wife was just a beard, and he was like, he met Scott, and he was like, all right, I'm ready to come out as gay.
Yeah, so Scott's definitely like the more flamboyant.
Right.
Stefan is more of like...
a little bit more reserved.
Yeah. But they're very good pair.
Yeah, they're so cute together. They are a pair from New York.
Mm-hmm.
They do also have another dog who is named... what's his name?
Tyrone.
Tyrone, yes.
Who is also a shih tzu.
Yes. But Miss Agnes is the one who is in the show.
Yes. Scott is played by John Michael Higgins. Stefan is played by Michael McKean.
Who we saw in Spinal Tap.
Yes.
Singing Big Bottoms!
The last dog is a standard poodle who is like the reigning champion of the show, I think.
Yeah, I think for 3 years she's won best in show.
Yeah, she is known as Rhapsody in White during the show, but I think her actual name that they call her outside of the show is just Butch.
There's a scene where they're going on a morning show and the show host is like, oh, so Butch is a bitch. That was cute.
So Butch's owners are Sherry Ann and this ancient man named Leslie.
Mm-hmm.
They are from Philadelphia. They're like, I don't know. I mean, I guess they like, they throw the party the night before the show.
Because mm-hmm. they were the winners, so they're like...
Well, they're also from Philadelphia. They're like the resident.
Yeah, they're like a rich couple.
Well, resident. Yes. Resident. They're like the resident participants of the show, I guess. So Leslie isn't really a part of anything.
Yeah, he's just the financier.
Yeah, I mean, so Sherry Ann is a gold digger. And she has... Mary Leslie, who will die at some point in the very near future, she will inherit his fortune. And I think more importantly to this movie, like inherit the bloodline of these show dogs.
Yes.
Yeah. For whatever that's worth.
Partnering with Sherry.
Yes.
Is Christy Cummings, who is played by Jane Lynch.
Yes.
What a queen. First of all, Jennifer Coolidge. Queen.
Yes.
So they enter the competition together,
mm-hmm.
And they are such a cute pair. Aside from Christy Cummings, we also have other side characters, such as Buck Laughlin.
Yeah, Buck Laughlin.
Buck Laughlin. Laughlin?
Laughlin.
Who is played by Fred Willis. He's like very suddenly become my favorite person in the world.
Okay.
He's so cute. And Trevor Beckwith, who is played by Jim Pidlock, Pidlock.
Yes.
Who I like kept recognizing, but I think I accidentally like either confused him for Edward Norton or the guy from Sky High. I don't know his name.
Okay. But yes. All right. They are both co-hosts of the show itself. Buck Laughlin is like completely ignorant to
dog shows.
The customs of dog shows. He is very dumb. And he tries to like make these.
He tries to bring entertainment to the show, but it's not that kind of show.
Right.
People are really serious about dogs.
Yeah, and Trevor is like a seasoned host, I guess. Mm-hmm. Very familiar with dog shows and the ins and outs of them and what they all mean.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So this whole movie was jam-packed with celebrities and comedians. And so for me, never watching this movie, it was such a throwback. Mm-hmm. And like just seeing tiny little like either featured guests or like little things mm-hmm. that were like, whoa, that was from the past that no longer exists or like are no longer relevant. The first thing, first person that I recognized, who I didn't even figure out who he was. And if we put a picture up, and we could probably figure out who he is. But it was the butcher.
Oh, okay.
I don't know if you know who he is.
I do not know his name.
But he straight up looks like AJ from NSYNC.
Okay.
No?
It is not AJ.
Okay, I know it's not AJ, but that's who he looks like. But I feel like I know who that face is. And if
AJ from NSYNC was like 17 years old when this movie came out or something. Not really. He's probably like 22.
But still, he was like too young to be that butcher. There was also, of course, Jane Lynch when she came up. Like, I was super excited to see her. I don't think I knew that she was in this movie.
Okay.
Even though she is on the cover, but I was really excited.
Even though
to see
we mentioned her in the previous episode.
I know. I forgot.
But yeah, Jane Lynch like looks so young.
She has not aged. She has looked 42 her whole life. Okay, maybe not 42.
No, she looks like a baby Jane Lynch in this movie.
No, she looked the same.
Jennifer Coolidge looks exactly the same.
Jennifer the Coolidge does look exactly the same. But
she just looks, Jane Lynch looks soft. And
softer.
She has,
okay.
Yeah, she's like so hard.
God, yeah. She looks like such a lesbian. Like, okay, so big spoiler.
Yeah.
At the end of the movie,
yeah,
Jane Lynch's character,
Christy Cummings,
wins her category with Rhapsody in White.
Yeah.
And in bliss and excitement for winning, she like goes to Sherry and just gives her a big old sloppy kiss. And it comes out, she's lesbian.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, first of all, if you know anything about Jane Lynch, you know that she's a fucking lesbian.
Yeah.
But there's also, like, tiny things that I felt, like, led up to this moment. Like, the butch is a bitch line.
Right.
What else?
There's, like, a conversation at the like, pre-show party
mm-hmm.
that Sherry Ann hosts. Christy is talking about how Sherry's gonna do her makeup.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And Sherry is like, yeah, it'll be really nice for me to, it'll be like relaxing for me to do her makeup, and it will show off my art. Anyway, they like have like this flirtation
mm-hmm.
that neither of them are aware of.
Right.
But like to the viewer, it's very obvious.
Yeah, and at the very beginning, Christy says something like, oh, we're like a couple, like a mom and dad and stuff like that. So like it sets up for them to be a couple at the end.
Yeah.
Which they are. They do end up being together at the end, and they host a little magazine, or they run a magazine called American Bitch, which is about female dogs. Oh no, it's about dogs and the women who own them.
Yes.
It's very cute. I love it. Oh yeah. One of the things that was like, oh my god, I totally forgot that this existed was a Bell South booth Like, oh, first of all, yeah. Bell South no longer exists. Uh-huh. I do know a couple people who still have a Bell South email, which I don't even know. Like, wow. Is the website still running?
Who knows?
And, like, just the idea of a phone booth. Like, I feel like they are, like, non-existent at this point. Hmm. Like, I've not seen a phone booth. Like, yeah. Even if I see, well, if I see, like, you know, the little, it's not even a phone booth, but, you know, like, in subways or whatever. They'll, like, have the like little the station. Phone? Yeah.
Yeah.
But they won't have the phones anymore.
Yeah.
Oh, yes. Okay. So, the next person for me that I spotted was this guy named Max. I do not remember what his whole purpose was.
I get the impression that you spotted people that you think are other people.
I know who this guy was. Okay. It did take me a while to figure out who he was. But he, Max, what did he do? Do you remember?
I don't remember Max.
Okay.
What does he look like?
So he looks like, okay, so he was on Princess Diaries. That's all I know. So he, okay. So Max, which we will put up his picture right here. I spotted him because he was on Princess Diaries. He was the hairdresser who turned Mia Thermopolis into a princess. Oh, and wow. So I was really excited to see his face because I couldn't remember if he was on Lizzie McGuire or Princess Diaries, but okay. I knew it was one of those.
Okay. All right. Nice.
So another thing is a cute little mention. When Cookie and Jerry get to the hotel, they incidentally cannot pay for their room. So the hotel staff tries really hard and to accommodate to them. And the only room available is a storage closet, pretty much.
Yeah.
And so they bring them in there and they were talking about all the cleaning supplies that they have. And the hotel manager is like, oh yeah, we have this bad boy here because we had like a rock group who just decided to pee all over the place. Yeah. Like animals. It was kind of foretold that the group that had stayed there that destroyed the place was Spinal Tap.
Yeah, I mean, it's not mentioned, but it's like an homage to Spinal Tap.
Yeah, it's very alluded.
Yeah, there was one other homage, I thought, when Harlan is on the way to the show, like on the way to Philadelphia,
mm-hmm.
he starts naming all of these nuts.
Oh, yeah.
And, you know, he names like pistachio nut, pine nut, and all these other nuts. And it's like a direct homage to Bubba and Forrest Gump naming all these shrimp.
Oh, okay.
And I don't know why that's I don't know why it's there, but it was hilarious.
I don't think it's not in the film though, is it? Yes, it is in the film because it's in the middle of my nuts. Okay.
Yeah.
I thought it was a deleted scene.
Yeah.
No, they left it in there.
Oh yeah, the beach balls are a deleted scene.
Oh yes, right? The beach balls are a deleted scene. It would have just been like a two out of the plot line to even insert.
Yeah.
But yeah, so that's pretty much all of my celebrity spotlights. aside from Phil's dad, I don't think I knew he was going to be in this movie. But I get really excited. That is Bill Howard, right? What's his name?
Bill Howard?
What's his name?
Fred Willard.
Who's Bill Howard? Fred Willard. I'm so bad with names. Anyways, Fred Willard.
Yeah.
I love him.
So there's a couple of other like details that specifically reference like, you know, a movie in the 2000s, basically.
Right.
Like something about 20 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
One of which, or the first one, I guess, was Meg and Hamilton talking about how they met each other.
Right.
And one of them was at a Starbucks. And the other one was at another Starbucks, like right across the street. And I don't remember what exactly happened, but they ended up like seeing each other. So the one went to the other Starbucks the next day.
So like the other one.
And then the other one went to the Starbucks that they saw the other one at. And anyway, it's just referencing like, I don't think this is the case so much anymore, but like when Starbucks was like booming in popularity,
right.
They were opening like stores everywhere.
Right.
Like, I mean,
they still do that now, but
I think it was really bad
in
the early 2000s. One other thing that could only be from like the late 90s or early 2000s is something that I felt or I witnessed growing up. And when Cookie and Jerry are checking in and their credit card or whatever is declined.
Yeah.
Cookie is like, no, we have two notices. We get two notices before they cut our card off or something like that. And like, they only received one notice apparently.
Yeah.
And their card's still not working. And just growing up, like, that's something that I witnessed my parents doing.
Oh no.
It was like writing checks to like utilities that they did not have the money for, you know? And like making the date like a couple days later, but just going ahead and sending the check to appease them.
Oh my god, yeah.
You know, like that kind
Damn,
of thing.
That's really funny. I do feel like the idea of like delis feels very early 2000s, or mainly 90s for me, but it could also be New York, like, center too, because Scott and what's his name,
Stefan,
who were in the deli, and I feel like delis just feel New Yorkian to me, but it feels very like 90s New Yorkian to me.
Yeah. So there's one other thing that I noticed, like, detail wise so they have like fictional cities like Fern City and what was the other, Pine Nut, North Carolina.
Yeah.
Like, those are fictional cities. Mm-hmm. They changed the name of the dog show.
Well, apparently they weren't allowed to, they asked around to shoot at an actual dog show, and no dog shows would let them do it.
Well, they also, like, you know, Philadelphia is a real city, and New York's a real city.
Yeah.
But the arena, the hotel is fictional. The venue in the hotel where the dog show is actually held, that's fictional. But then they also like have very specific like product placements, like in Jerry and Cookie's RV.
Okay.
They're like driving and you see like a Coke and like Oreos
set
up on the dash. The intro to the dog show itself says it's sponsored by Iams and Yukonoba.
What is that? Computers?
No, it's a dog.
Oh, dog food. Okay.
Yeah, Yukonoba, whatever that is.
I'm a dog person.
And then Hamilton is talking about taking off this turtleneck and putting on another turtleneck.
Oh, from J. Crew.
From Saks Fifth Avenue.
Oh, okay. But they were really into J. Crew.
They were into J. Crew. And Megan Hamilton also run into Harlan.
Mm-hmm.
Harlan's going on about what fly to use for what fish or whatever. And Hamilton just like interrupts him and is like, is that L.L. Bean?
Oh, yeah! Talking about his shirt. That's so cute. And I think at some point Meg and Hamilton were like looking at like a Sears catalog or something like that. Huh. Like that was like their couple time, just like reading catalogs together. There's a, I don't know. I think the idea of them is like very cute. Like just being like one of those like couples who just like want to fit in.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like they just have that energy.
Yeah. I thought it was strange. So like I went into this movie having never seen it before. I thought it was just gonna like, you know, make fun of these like crazy dog show people, like,
right,
people obsessed with their dogs, take them to dog shows and stuff, but it really doesn't do that.
No,
like Meg and Hamilton are really the outliers. Like,
right,
they make a fool of themselves.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they're overzealous with how much they care for their dog, and like that's what I was expecting.
Mm-hmm.
But it's really respectful to like the four other dogs and their owners slash handlers.
Right.
And I don't know, I thought that was unique.
Yeah, I do really love Harlan when he like is like, you know, getting his dog ready, and then Christy comes up and she's like, oh, this is like a fine dog. And it's like, I love the way that they like touch the dogs, if that makes sense, because it's with such care and like love. Even though it's like not their real dogs, you know.
Mm-hmm.
One of the things that I found funny is like at some point they were judging the poodles, and it's like a small dog, and they, like
the
they grabbed
poodles.
It by like the neck. You know what I'm saying? It was like really weird. I was like, I don't think that's how you hold dogs, but I guess it is. I mean, I'm not a, I don't deal with dogs. I'm not a dog show host, so. Maybe that is how you hold
You're
up.
Not a dog show host.
No, sadly, no. But yeah, I just thought it was weird because they just lifted by the neck.
So one other detail that I really liked, when Cookie and Jerry were leaving before they left for the show.
Oh yeah, before they left for the show.
Yeah, they were having like a farewell party, I mm-hmm. guess, and they had a banner made that said, "Good luck, Winky."
Oh, dude, Winky is so cute. I love Winky. Out of all the dogs, Winky was my favorite.
Yeah.
So talking about Winky, and minor and like details of the movie. One of the things that I really love was the fashion of this movie.
Oh, okay.
And speaking of fashion and Winky, Jerry has a little Winky hat.
Oh, yeah.
Did you see that? Yeah, he has a hat, like this little cap that has like Winky on it. And like you can see it when Winky's training. You can see him wearing it in like the car and stuff like that. I think that's so, so cute.
He has it on when they get to the hotel.
Yeah. they love Winky so much. Another, like, really big fashion moment is I love how both Meg and Hamilton have braces. That is so cute to me. Apparently, Parker Posey, the actress who does Meg, got, like, real braces for this film. It's like, you don't need to go there, but I want to do that. So, I get it. I get it. Braces are cute. Also, there's a scene where Jane Lynch and Jennifer Coolidge are like talking outside with the interviewer.
Yeah.
And Jennifer Coolidge has like this giant headband thing. I think it goes all around her head, but it's like a head warmer. But like, I don't know if she's wearing it wrong or it just goes around your head, because there's no back to it. Hmm. It's just like around her face.
Weird.
Yeah, it's like really big and thick. And I think that's cool. I like it. Bring it back. And then Sherry's dress at her party, when it's like this beautiful like red dress, like uh-huh. Jennifer Coolidge, I mean, first of all, always hot, but like she just looks so regal.
Her red bra is,
yeah, so. You know, as regal as Jennifer Coolidge characters can be. Jerry's suit. Jerry wears like this almost like wine or maroon colored suit.
Oh yeah.
At the pre-party, like the mingling party. And I don't know, I think that's really cute for like someone like Jerry to have. It feels very Floridian. It's like a Floridian color. I thought those were very, very cute.
I do think Cookie, Catherine O'Hara's character, had like lip liner.
Okay.
In a couple of scenes.
Oh, okay. There are a couple of scenes where she looks like Jennifer Aniston, like from Friends. Like, because she has like this like almost icy pink lip gloss liner, and like her hair is like pulled back, and she looks straight up like, what's her name in Friends?
Rachel?
Yeah, she straight up looks like Rachel.
Yeah.
All right. And then coming out with a bang, last outfit was probably my favorite. Was I'm sorry, I'm choking up. Was Scott's outfit for the best in show category. He comes out and like, you know, he has his whole getup put on. He's like, look, if my dog's not gonna win best in show, I'm gonna win best dressed or whatever. And I loved it. Yeah, really good 90s fashion.
I think he has like padded shoulders on this big blazer.
I think he's wearing like eyeliner too.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. I love it.
So I thought like the funniest part of the movie was like the quotes.
Yes.
Like there are so many good ones. So I wanted to go through like some of my favorite quotes.
Okay, give me your favorite quotes.
So Jerry and Cookie are at Cookie's like ex's house or friend or whatever, and you know, they show up, this guy like starts making out with Cookie just like impromptu.
Oh, yeah.
And it's like super like cringy for both Jerry and the guy's wife. I don't know their names. And they start eating dinner or whatever.
How do you just casually go into dinner?
Anyway, during dinner he like crosses the line and Jerry's like, this guy is an animal. Fine, I'm just gonna say it. You're talking to the guy's wife. He says, your luscious melon breasts look very nice
today. That's right, I have that on there. He's like, what if I told your wife your luscious melon breasts? And she's like, thank you.
When he's getting that out, when he's saying that, Cookie and her are like having this exchange, and she says, pinata, I don't even know what a pinata is. Like, it gets hidden, like you barely hear it.
Yeah.
But it's such a funny line. When they're at the party, another contestant in the dog show,
mm-hmm.
He recognizes Cookie. And
oh, yeah, that's right.
He says, I banged a lot of waitresses in my day, but you were definitely the best.
She's like, you don't forget the best. Dude, even, what's his name? Fucking Fred. Fred Willard, he's the co-host. He, when Cookie comes to present Winky, Fred's character is like, that handler looks very familiar to me. Dude, the whole time we're just introduced to all the men. Well, maybe not all of the men, because she's had thousands. That's another one of my favorites is when Jerry's like, oh yeah, my wife, she's had hundreds of lovers. And she's like, hundreds? It's more like the thousands. they were really cute. Okay, I love when Scott and Stefan are like in their hotel room with Miss Agnes, and then they get on the phone and they're like, oh, where's Tyrone? Like, with their dog sitter, like, put Tyrone on the phone. Like, hi Tyrone, how are you? It's like, it's a dog.
And they're like, I can hear him breathing.
Did they tell him he was allowed to watch TV or something for like an hour?
When they're packing, before they leave,
mm-hmm.
they're packing, and Scott is talking about like bringing a seventh kimono. And Stefan, he's like, how many is that? And Scott's like, seven. And Stefan says, we're going to be in Philadelphia for 48 hours. And Scott says, you're right, I should bring one more.
I love Scott.
And then my favorite line is when they're in the pre-show party.
Mm-hmm.
Scott and Stefan are talking to Jerry and Cookie, and Scott introduces Stefan as, quote, this is my euphemism, Stefan.
Aww.
It's such a funny thing to call somebody your euphemism, like, you're not even gonna make up a euphemism.
When Harlan leaves to go to Philly, I think it's his brother or something, says to Herbert, you put them hurt on them Yankee dogs. And yeah. I think that's really cute, like, just to like pep talk the dog. My last favorite quote is probably when Sherry is being interviewed with Leslie,
mm-hmm.
and she's like, oh yeah, we have so much we love together, like soup and snow peas, and we could talk all day, and we could also talk, we could also not talk all day. There's so much things that we cannot talk about. Dude, I love her. So apparently this whole like good bit of this film is like improvised, like,
I would assume,
like,
so
you can pretty much tell.
Yeah.
But I mean,
the part where he's listing off nuts, that is 1000% improvised.
Yeah.
Because he gets like three nuts out and he's like, pine nut.
But I think he says, it works.
That is a nut, but it's also the name of a town.
It works because they're all comedians. And yeah. So, like, you know, they all have funny things to say.
Yeah, yeah. All right, so that kind of brings us into our ratings.
Yes.
Let me go first.
Okay.
All right, so I'm just going to say it. I wanted this movie to be better than it was.
Okay.
It was not up to my expectations.
Okay, it was not best in show.
It was not best in show. It was... It was funny. It wasn't like laugh out loud funny.
Right.
Like, there's a lot of like quick little dialogue things, mm-hmm. that are really funny.
Yes.
But there's not that much going on. Also, I hate ventriloquists.
I hate them. I fucking hate ventriloquists.
And for that reason, I'm giving this movie a 5.4.
I thought you were going to say, for that reason, I'm out.
For that reason, I'm giving this movie a 5.4.
Damn. All right. I gave this movie a 5.35.
5.35?
Yes.
Okay, so we're very close to each other.
So literally just half a 0.5.
Yes, 0.5. No, 0.5.
Yeah, 0.5.
0.05.
0.05, yes.
How'd you get that number?
So, I felt the same way about you. I wanted this movie to be way funnier than it was.
Okay, yeah.
It was
yeah.
still funny, but yes. just not as funny as I thought it would be having this sort of cast.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I think it is because it was improvised. I mean, they're like, they have funny quotes and they are like, great actors, but there's like, you know, they're just doing their own thing, and sometimes that's just not hilarious.
Yeah, I mean, I just thought it was too big of a scope, like mm-hmm. there's too many characters,
right?
And you don't have enough time. Like, I would much rather this movie just be about Harlan, Cookie and Jerry, and Sherry Ann. That's it.
Okay.
Like, I don't need Megan Hamilton.
I like Megan Hamilton. Yeah, I didn't... Okay, so I was watching it, I didn't like them. But mm-hmm. then, like, stepping back, I was like, actually, I love them. I would have just watched a movie about Megan Hamilton.
I don't know.
But, okay, yes. But I did feel like it was too big of a cast. Too mm-hmm. much going on.
Yeah.
And, like, you know, I had to, like, bump it down for like cinema, sound, edit, like it's just basic.
Yeah.
So like it's a basic movie, and the 0.05 comes in is in my enjoyment, because I wanted to give it a 7.
Okay.
But I was like, I don't know.
It's just slightly better than a 7.
It's slightly better than a 7.
Okay.
Cuz I did like it, and it was very quotable, and I mean, I don't know. I would watch it again, but I would... Actually, no, I probably wouldn't. And I think that's what it is.
Fair enough. All right. What is your one favorite thing about the movie?
My favorite thing has to be the kiss.
The kiss at the end. Oh,
yes.
Between Sherry Ann
okay. and Christy Cummings. Okay. Because, I mean, yes, I knew they were lesbians together, but, like, there was just... I was in shock. I was not expecting that.
Okay.
What's your favorite thing?
So my one favorite thing is when Scott and Stefan are back in their hotel room right before they make the phone call.
Yes.
I think it's Scott is like nailing up like some sort of like tapestry blanket thing.
Yeah.
It's like a quilt.
Yeah.
He's like nailing up above the bed for like a headboard.
Yeah.
And they put like they've hung other things on the wall.
Like they just make it their own. Like they live here now for the next 48 hours.
Like they have moved into the hotel room just temporarily.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. I do love that very much. Yeah. But, All right.
So, cool.
That was a dog show.
That was a best in show.
That was best in show.
All right. So, of course, that movie is about dogs.
Mm-hmm.
Our next episode will focus on one of the following three movies, all of which have dog in their title.
Dog.
Yes. Very clear connection to best in show.
Yes.
All right. You want to take it away?
Yeah. So, the movies that we have for you to pick is... A, Amores Perros, which came out in the 2000s, directed by Alejandro Iñárritu.
Yeah.
That is also following dog owners and their life and how their dogs fit into it.
Okay. I've never seen
it. Yeah. It's a pretty intense movie. Uh-huh. I personally really love it. I did have a hard time watching it the first time, but I will watch it again. B, we have Dogtooth, which came out in 2009, and it was directed by Yorgos Lanthimos, and we don't know anything about it, but
no,
the poster for it looks really cool, so we're really excited to see it.
Yeah.
And then we have C, Reservoir Dogs, which came out in 1992, directed by Quentin Tarantino, which, I mean, I really don't know what it's about. Do you know what it's about?
Yeah.
What is it about?
No, I mean, why?
Okay, Well, I know that Steve Buscemi's in it, and I will watch it for that reason.
All right. Quentin Tarantino is also in it.
Yeah, I fucking hate that guy.
And with that,
Thank you so much for watching us.
Yeah, thanks for watching. if you have not already, you gotta subscribe to this channel, man.
Yeah, please subscribe to us. We would love to see you, your little icon on the subscription.
Yeah, we gotta get those subscribers up so we can get our URL
down.
Yeah.
So we can get them coins in.
No, if we get like 100 subscribers, we can change the URL.
Oh yeah, dude, get us to 100 subscribers so we can change our URL.
Yeah, let's do that.
Yes.
Share us with your friends. It's necessary.
And don't forget to also follow us on social media. We are There Will Be Podcasts on Instagram, and you can also vote there. And we are also Pod From a Basket on Twitter, which you can also vote there. You can also vote in the comments, and we're also on Spotify.
Yeah, so the videos are now on Spotify.
Yeah, dude, so, you can watch us on Spotify.
Yeah.
And subscribe to us there. Yeah, we would really appreciate it.
Yeah. Thank you so much. We're going to do some parting words, I believe.
Yes, parting words, parting words.
And thank you.
Thank you so much. Have a good night. Woof.
God loves a terrier. Yes, he does. God loves a terrier. That's because small, sturdy, bright, and true, they'll give their love to you. God didn't miss a stitch. Be a dog or be a bitch. When he made the Norwich merrier with its cute little terrier. Yes, God loves a terrier.